Good morning. It is currently Tuesday morning, and I will be multitasking while talking to you. I need to get a bunch of Valentines made up for work, so I just need to start tearing stuff apart, which may be a slight noise that you hear on top of the jingle of the cat and the weird clicking noise thing for our timers, for our lights that we have above our cabinets. Janisa got like a string of lights. You can see them handed out over there. Pretty cool. Like fairy lights or, they kind of remind me of San Antonio. They're neat. Lights that if we had that immaculate backyard, that's what we would hang from the trees for sure. Hope you guys had a good week. I had a great weekend. It was fantastic. The people that I play games with on Monday nights, they'll get together early and practice music, but I'm never able to make it because I have to do family fun night for Chick-fil-A. And so one of them was like, well, we know how hard it is for you to get there early to practice, so we'll come and practice at your house some Saturday. So Saturday, this past Saturday, was the day that we all decided, hey, there's nothing going on. We can actually do it this week. So they drove up here to East Nashville, and two of them brought guitars, and then Stephanie came and was just content to sit there, but I felt bad, like she was being left out. So I got her my djembe that I have, and not djembag, because I've definitely had that misunderstood before, a djembe, which is a drum. And she kind of would sit there and try to play the drum, but she sat in Janice's chair, the gray one that's right back there, and that is the cuddle chair for the cat. And he was like, you are in my domain, that is now my lap. There he goes. And Stephanie was even to the point where she was trying to play the drum like this while the cat was laying down on top of her hands, and it was stinking adorable. So they came over, and then since we typically play board games every Monday night, I was like, well, there's a coffee shop close by that is really fun that we went to for the first time that has all these board games. Do you guys want to go play? They're like, sure, yeah. So we went to that same coffee shop that we went to with Kayla. The coffee shop is called Bongo East, so like there's a Bongo coffee company in Nashville, but this one is also called Game Point, which I guess is what they title the board game sort of stuff going on. So we went there, and I have a photo. Actually, I have a couple of photos. So someone that works there saw us playing and was like, hey, is it cool if we take a picture? We're like, sure. So they took a photo of us posing, and then they took another photo of us actually playing. But we're all wearing glasses that are blackout glasses. Like, we can't see a thing. And this is a game, I'm gonna mispronounce the name of it, I know it. Nectophobia? It's like the fear of the dark. They have a whole section of board games for visually impaired, so like, that blind people can play. And Janisa found it and pulled it, and we're like, yeah, that sounds fun. So we grabbed it, and you play it with a maximum of 5 people. And I'm just tearing these again. I'm gonna tilt this down a little bit so you can see what my hands are doing. Push you a little bit further back. There we go. So 4 people cannot see. They have to play by touch alone. And the premise is they have a friend who has become separated from them and is lost in the woods. The 5th person is the vampire, and they are trying to, kill everybody. That's the whole point. So the vampire is the only one that can see, and like each person's turn starts with the vampire guiding their finger to their game piece, and then you can feel a spot around your game piece to see what's going on. Cause like there's trees set up on the board, there's edges of the board, there's other players that you can find. But then if you touch the vampire's game piece, you have to go into combat. And if you touch the vampire's game piece twice, you die. And everybody loses the game. So Stephanie was the vampire, and she did a really good job for someone who's never played the game before at like making it difficult for us, but also being fair to herself. She did really good. She's awesome. But they loved the game shop, which was fantastic. That was fun to do. So I don't know, like, the next time they're coming up here for us to kind of try to play music together, but they apparently aren't really used to like reading, like playing worship music. They typically play rock music together. So we kind of butchered Lynyrd Skynyrd's Simple Man together. But I mean, it was fun. I think it was their first time ever seeing an upright bass. Like, yes, this is my instrument. This is the thing of which I can use to make sense in the world. That's this right here. This is the first time we've really hung out outside of the typical game night that Stephanie hosts, or outside of Kairos. Because we run into each other at Kairos, and Chris has joined us at our table a couple of times. But, I mean, we don't really do a whole lot else. But I think all of them have family down here, and like are really active, and Stephanie's very active with Kairos. Like, she is a greeter and someone who is like, oh, well, let's get you in a Bible reading group. That kind of jazz. Speaking of a Bible reading group, They've been really pushing it a lot for like the church that we go to on Sunday, Avenue South, the one that I play at. I mean, to be fair, Kairos really pushes it a lot too, especially since Kairos is an affiliate of Brentwood Baptist. It's very, you need to find other Christians to help you in your walk sort of a deal. Like our church has, Janissa went through a mentorship placement thing and she now has a mentor. And we also did a Discover Us class where we kind of got to learn more about Brentwood Baptist and what they believe sort of a deal. And then this last Sunday we did a Discover You class where you take like a placement, personality assessment sort of a deal. It's like to figure out what your spiritual gifts are and just where you kind of fit in, which I have that here at the table. So this is a book that we got from it, Finding Your Place. It's got a lot of really cool stuff in it. It's just kind of like, what is a spiritual gift sort of deal? Because like, I was always raised thinking, okay, so I remember talking to mom when I was really little in the car. She was getting gas before dropping us off at the daycare in Huntertown where we used to go with Louise and Rachel. I remember asking mom, like, what makes you a Christian? Mom's like, well, you ask Jesus into your heart. I'm like, well, I want to be like mom. So I remember staring at this gas station sign and being like, Jesus, please come into my heart. And that was like me accepting Christ. And then another time I went to Bear Lake Camp and they're like, have you made this decision for you? And I'm like, no. So I accepted Christ into my life for me and not just to be like mom. But I mean, even then I was still younger than when I was probably 10. But, I mean, it's a decision that I still hold myself to. But it's also a decision that I'm needing to reaffirm for myself now and be like, okay, so like, if this is really a thing you're doing, how are you adjusting your personal schedule and what the things that you like and want to include this life that you have seeking Christ? Anyway, oh, the spiritual gifts. So I also remember asking mom, I'm like, mom, everybody who's a Christian gets a spiritual gift. She's like, yes. I'm like, well, what's mine? She's like, you don't know what yours is because I can tell you exactly what it is. I'm like, okay. She goes, think about it. And then she never answered the question, which was a very mom thing to do. I was like, okay, is she talking about like musical skills? Like that's my spiritual gift. And that's why I've always been so good at music, is because I asked God into my heart as a little kid. And like, this is part of my God-given talent. And part of the thing that they answered here was like sense of humor, talent, skill. Like those are not spiritual gifts. Spiritual gifts are something that specifically help the body of Christ. And while those are things that could help the body of Christ, those are things that are yours and not given, not like a, this is really sounding weird. So like everything's given to you by God, but not like, what's the thing that said? I'm pretty sure I underlined it and I'm just butchering it, trying to repeat it back to you. Okay, so spiritual gifts are not natural talents. So not like humor or intelligence. Those are given to the entire human race and they may become a gift at spiritual conversion, but it is not a spiritual gift. Spiritual gifts are not fruit of the Spirit. Fruit of the Spirit is an extension of the character of Christ. And a spiritual gift is also not a role, like pastor. And then it has, for example, God calls all Christians to many roles without them having spiritual gifts in that area. And then we read a few verses that listed like specific spiritual gifts. So we read Romans 12, 3 through 8, 1 Corinthians 12, 4 through 1, 1 Corinthians 12, 14 through 31, Ephesians chapter 4, verses 5 through 7, and 11 through 12, and 1 Peter chapter 4 verses 10 through 11. And all of this kind of like as a group listed everything all up on the whiteboard. So lists of spiritual gifts that they had us go through: evangelism, discernment, helping, pastor, shepherd, wisdom, faith, knowledge, leadership, giving, teaching, mercy, prophecy, service, hospitality, encouragement, and administration. So it rated us on a scale and like we got points for every question we answered. So like my highest rated ones, this administration was my top one with 32. Encouragement was my next one with 29. Hospitality was my next one with 27. Service and prophecy were my next ones, rated at 26. And mercy was my next one, rated at 25. I don't know, at first seeing them, I was like, really? And then like she started talking through some stuff and giving examples. And I was like, oh, yeah, that makes sense. I answered questions that would define my personality blend, my spiritual gifts, my awareness of my abilities that I have, which I'm sure it'll be a shock to you to learn that artistic ability was my highest one, which is actually tied with conventional and social. Just don't know how I feel about that. We didn't go over that in class. So I'm sure if we had gone over it, I would have been like, oh yeah. And then we also went over our passions that we have.
have.
And then they had a section for experiences of life, where basically you just wrote down your experiences. They had a limit of characters, which is good because I ran out. So going over that as a group with other people that were also interested helped take a little bit of the awkward off, and not quite so much like, oh, I'm an adult that still doesn't know my place or understand like how I see the world or how I view the world. So it was helpful to have that. Other people are struggling too. What a shock. That was Sunday. Another first we did on Thursday was we went to, there's a Bible reading group very close to our house. We had never gone to before. And Janice was always like, well, it's on Thursdays, we should just go. And every Thursday I was like, I have to edit this video, I can't. And then she would just stay home with me because an object at rest tends to stay at rest. But we both went this past Thursday and it was worth it. Not what I expected. And also everybody there wasn't quite a stranger. And like there was someone else there that was brand new that also plays Pokemon Go, and so like we got to bond over that. But the girl that hosts it is actually engaged to a guy that helps run sound at the church and helped like get me trained, initiated, whatever you want to call it, and who was very insightful and very knowledgeable in helping me get everything set up. I mean, that was cool. So, because she's like, oh, well, I'm engaged to John, the guy that does sound. I'm like, oh, the guy that majorly helped me out and taught me some stuff. She's like, yeah, that's the guy. And apparently he's normally there, but he had work that day. But our Sunday church is going through the book of Mark, just like one chapter at a time each Sunday. Bible study group is also going through the book of Mark. Like total crazy random happenstance. They didn't plan it that way. And I'm really feeling like God's being like, all right, so I am making it really super easy for somebody who's incredibly dumb to learn slowly how to delve into my word. And I am giving you people teaching you things as help. So I am trying to be wise and going, oh, okay, this is for me. Take heed. Actually read things and follow through. Thank you for spending some time with me while I multitask. I'm sorry, I have a ton of stuff that I need to do. I'm making the best of both worlds, okay? But I hope that you guys have a great week. And I will see you next week.